for a while, we didn't sell them.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Everybody was just walking over, so they could just strip and get thrown out. T-shirts, jeans.
That should have made the movie. I mean, you know, they were hog farmers giving away goulash and all that.
Rural,
more rural. So it was serious, you know, amounts of, you had hundreds of jeans and stuff like that.
Yeah. It's a lot of money. Yeah. We could have made.
And you were what? 12 years old at the time.
Yeah.
I was up in Maine, and we didn't know about Woodstock. We didn't make it up there. And a friend of mine, my job, I had a great job for Trinket Brothers Construction Company. They built bridges, and I was painting. I painted half the bridges on 95. But at this point in time, there was no bridges. So I was down there digging a hole, you know, just killing time, you know. And a friend comes by from college. He says, "Hey, I'm going to Arizona. My brother's taking me down to Mexico. You want to go?" And I went, "Okay." So I threw my shovel down. I got my paycheck. And off we went. And I get to Phoenix area. We went to VW Bug. And I get there on a Friday night. And in Phoenix, freaking Arizona, they're talking about, they closed the interstate, the New York State Freeway. Listen to this music festival, Woodstock. And I'm like, oh,
what am I doing in Arizona?
And, you know, I went to Mexico.
Right.
Then I came back.
Never the same.
With, you know, and we drove back, all the way back, with a kilo of pot on our front seat. Two hippies in a VW Bug with a hair down to here. Who would ever think to pull this off? So I came back with dysentery, a clown, and a kilo of pot.
All these years, I've never heard this story. So this is
it. All right, here we go. I'm sorry, sweetheart. You didn't need to hear that. This is my wife, Dodie, by the way. We got married. You're Dodie's wife. And we met in 1979 when you played lead guitar on one of our albums. And here we are. 40 years later.
Took a long time.
Oh,
bookends is kind of like Paul Simon's song cycle about life. He throws the duo into the concept album sweepstakes, and along with classic albums like Pet Sounds and Sgt. Pepper, they offer their life cycle on that side. Side two, they collect some songs that had been out as singles, but had not yet appeared on an album. And one of those songs, which we all really love, is the one that you're about to hear. And Miss Dodie's going to get electric. There you go. So, yeah, another round of applause for Jeff. Give it up. Without Jeff, we can, and Brian, we don't. Anyway, this song proved that not only could Simon. This song proved that not only can Simon and Garfunkel go through a wispy, delicate number like Scarborough Fair, they could also rock and roll. Hope you enjoyed that. It's a very good shape.
Thing.
I don't know, Elvis.
wrong chords.
You wouldn't think they just did it for you. Signifies a quantum leap for Paul Simon songwriting. It's a song that was written up in the New York Times by Stephen Holden, and this is what he said about it. Fritz always hates when I goof on this, but America from the Bookends album is 3.5 minutes of sheer brilliance, whose unforced narrative, alternating precise detail with sweeping observation, evokes the panorama of a restless paved America, and simultaneously illuminates a drama of shared loneliness on a bus trip with cosmic implications. Simple.
Hey.
That is great writing.
You shouldn't make fun of that, right? That's Pulitzer Prize.
Yeah, well, but the song is also used to great effect by Cameron Crowe in a film called Almost Famous. Again, thank you all for coming. Keeps everyone safe. Isn't it cool how he does that? I don't know how he does that. Sound my call's time. Whoa, not good. Card error on that? No, that can't be good. Oh, wow. See, that's the little machine that's been recording some of this evening's event. Well, we'll be back tomorrow night here at the Promo of Delivery, bringing you the Simon Garfunkel songbook. You guys are just going to camp out. Thankfully, there are three other cameras. Look at the digital age, man. Back in the old days, you put a tape in, you know, you watch the tape go around. As long as the tape was moving, you know, your butt was pretty safe, you know. Now it's like you put a digital card in, and you have no idea what is going on. So, Jeff knows all. Yeah. See how it goes. All right, Jeff. Are we all right? Jeff's going to give us a thumbs up. Without Jeff's thumb, we don't... Because it's... It's true, man. That's... When the Aztec Two-Step archive opens, we're going to have this. I know.
I can't afford Garfunkel's wig. I would have it just.
We could take. Here's he goes.
Okay.
Thank you. continued to raise the bar in contemporary pop music when he wrote a song for the Bookends album that contained the line, "Can you imagine us years from today sharing a park bench quietly? How terribly strange to be 70. Well, if you haven't already done the math from the first half of the show, Paul Simon reached that milestone on October 13, 2011, and Artie followed him to that milestone a few weeks later on November 5th. How terribly strange to be 78, indeed. Here is sometime soon. The guys are going to do a song with the song that Paul Simon wrote, called Old Friends. Oh, we're doing something different than Old Friends? Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. Right in the joint, are you? Here the guy is. The incredible shrinking Rex Fowler.
Are you all set now, Logan?
I tell you what, though. I took my son to see Sinatra at Radio City when my son graduated from high school, Music and Art High School. Very nice. And by the way, that was one of my best parenting achievements, was turning my son on to Sinatra after his heinous grandmother poisoned him against Sinatra, because apparently for some personality flaws or something like that.
Random mafia connections.
Yes, but I always thought that Sinatra could have killed this song.
Yeah.
Yes.
Absolutely.
I wish he'd done.
But his old friends would have probably looked very different than the group of Paul Simon's old friends. Sharing a park bench with Sam Giancana. I don't know.
Settle like dust on the shore.
Eleanor Roosevelt and Joe DiMaggio, you know. And Mike Nichols is